Let's look at the solution for our control dependence quiz in a pipeline. We know how many instructions are taken branches. We don't really care that it's a 10-stage pipeline. What we care about is that the branches are resolved in the 6th stage and that everything else works smoothly. So the actual CPI will be 1 per instruction. This happens for branches and all the other instructions, plus for every taken branch, and that happens 25% of the instructions, we have a penalty of 5 cycles. Why? Because when we resolve the branch in the 6th stage, there have already been 5 stages worth of instructions that we fetched from the wrong place and we have to throw them away. So following a branch like this, there will be 5 cycles in which we don't finish anything. So we spend 1 cycle per instruction, and for 25% of instructions, we spend additional 5 cycles for that instruction. Basically, there are 5 empty cycles after it. If you multiply this out, you get 2.25. As you can see, this CPI is very far from the ideal. Our processor is less than half as fast as it would be without the taken branches.